What's up, guys? It's Widgeon TV here. Today, I'm going to be talking about a topic that I've wanted to cover since the low rank, and that is attack up or critical eye. Comparing these armor skills is important because both of them do essentially the same thing. They boost your damage. Both of them go about it a little bit differently, but with a little bit of math, you can convert critical eye directly into attack boost. So that raises the question, if I had an armor piece with 2 points of critical eye or an armor piece with 2 points of attack boost, which one should I choose? Well, today I'm going to answer that question. Now, before I go any further, I need to let everybody know that this is going to be a numbers heavy video. So if you're not interested in my calculations or how I did any of this, I'll put a timestamp in the description below so you can skip forward. But if you are interested in the numbers, let's dig into this. So there are 7 ranks with both of these skills. Attack boost simply gives you more attack, but then at level 4 it will also give you an extra 5% affinity. Critical eye is a little bit simpler, but it does ramp up right in the middle. It goes from giving you an extra 3% every rank to an extra 5%. So it will be interesting to see how that affects the results. So I decided to test this on 3 different weapons, and since I personally main the greatsword, I decided to test all of this on greatswords. First, we have the Zeno Malik. I picked this greatsword because it has a low base attack and a high base affinity. Next up, we have the Purgation's Atrocity. I picked this one because it has a high base attack, but it also has 0% affinity, so this will be kind of a baseline. And then lastly, we have the Anguish. I picked this one because of its extremely high base damage and the fact that it has negative 30% affinity. I picked these 3 weapons because I think they accurately represent the spectrum of weapons in Monster Hunter World. That being some with a low affinity and high attack, and some with high affinity and low attack, and everything in between. So in order to compare these 2 skills, we're going to have to reduce these weapons' attack to its true raw form. You do this by dividing the weapon's attack value by the specific weapon class's bloat factor number. In this case, that number is 4.8. So here are the weapon's true raw attacks: Zeno Malik with 170, Purgation's Atrocity with 210, and Anguish with 230. Now, when you adjust all of these for their base affinity, you get something a little bit different. Zeno goes up by 6, Atrocity obviously stays the same, and Anguish is reduced by 17. Now that we have these weapons' final attack value, let's start applying these skills. Now, theoretically, Critical Eye should work better on the higher attack value weapons. So that being said, let's start with the lowest attack value weapon and move up. So starting with the Zeno Malik, I went through the trouble of applying every single rank of each perk to the base attack value. This is a lot of numbers, I know, but there are 2 key points to look at here, and those are rank 1 of each skill and rank 7 of each skill. So as you can see here, attack up is beating critical eye at rank 1 by about 2 damage. These are rounded up just for reference. And then by rank 7, attack up is still in the lead, but this time by about 11 points, which is fairly substantial. And to note, critical eye at no point in the middle of this list gets even close. So obviously, in this case, attack boost is far superior than critical eye. But like I said, critical eye should get more effective the higher we go, so don't count it out yet. Next up, we have the Purgation's Atrocity. Now, looking at the same places as we did the first time, rank 1 and rank 7, as you can see, critical eye starts out losing by about 2 points, and then at rank 7, it ends up losing even harder, this time by about 8 points. So as you can see, the gap is closing. Last time at rank 7 it was 11 points, this time it's 8 points. Let's see if Anguish can lower that number. So here's Anguish's chart. As you can see, looking at the first and last again, the story is still the same, but this time at rank 7 it is only losing by 5 points. So theoretically, if there was a weapon that was powerful enough, critical eye would eventually do more damage than attack up. And well, in Monster Hunter World there are ways that you can raise your attack, things like food buffs and demon drug. So that raises the question, can we get enough attack that we can make critical eye better than attack up? Well, I'll give it my best shot, so let's take everything. I'll equip the Power Charm and Power Talon, that gives you an extra 15 raw damage. On top of that, we'll do the Attack Up Large food buff, which also gives you plus 15 raw attack. We'll use a Mega Demon Drug, which is plus 7 raw attack, a Might Seed, which is plus 10 raw attack, and then redo the calculations. So applying all these buffs to Anguish, we can immediately look down at rank 7 and see that there is only a 2-point difference between these 2 armor skills. But attack boost still comes out victorious. So now you may be asking, is Critical Eye ever worth picking? And thankfully, yes. There is the obvious case where if you already have attack boost rank 7, then obviously Critical Eye is the next best place to go. But beyond that, there is the elephant in the room, and that is critical boost. Now, I'm not going to cover that in this video, but I think I am going to make a mock armor build guide video to show you the most effective way to use Critical Eye, so look for that in the future. And to wrap it up for the people who skipped forward, on all weapons, no matter if it has high base attack and low base affinity, or low base attack and high base affinity, attack boost will always give you more attack than Critical Eye, even with stacking all of the buffs in the game. So if you have that decision between one armor piece that has attack boost and one armor piece that has Critical Eye, then I would always recommend going for attack boost. So that's all I have on these two armor skills. I hope everybody enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to like and consider subscribing. It really helps out my small channel. Also, consider following me on Twitter. It's the best place for me to keep in contact with you guys. But anyway, this has been WoodGenTV. Thanks for watching, guys.